Hey, it's Mike with Narcoleptic Customs. Tonight, this is the Stanley LS swap video number 3. I'm going to sit out here with my daughters, and we're going to go over a couple of the differences in the engines here, kind of let them ask some questions. I'll answer what I can, and then also explain some of the differences. So, Peyton, you want to go ahead and have a...
That sounds good. Can you take all of the parts out and away from each other? Like, if we had...
Oh, and Mommy's here!
Like, if we had this part, could we take it off of this or something? And, like, could all these parts go apart?
Oh, yeah, for sure. See, like that engine I have over there?
Yeah.
I took it all apart. So, yeah, we can take them apart. I don't want to do that with this engine, though, because I want this engine to get shiny and pretty and be put on the engine stand so I can tell people about, you know, Papa's story and what he did and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. So I think that's the plan for this engine. Gracie, did you have a question about the motors?
What's that truck over there?
That truck over there is Project Elsie. And I have a whole video series on it. So if you hit the subscribe button and go down, I'm going to have some video updates on it coming this week. So the main differences between these two is obviously technology.
Okay.
So there's a lot more technology that's in that one than there is in this one. So this
is
one...
Is that the old motor?
Mm-hmm, this is the old motor. So
that's the new motor?
Mm-hmm. So the older motors aren't as... efficient as the new ones. So that's why I'm going to that one, because it'll drive, like I said last time, it'll drive like Daddy's Avalanche did, or Mama's Pilot. I can go out and get in and start it and drive it. And it'll be easy.
My other question was, what happens if a bug gets in the motor?
What happens if a bug gets in the motor? That's a good question. So if it's a small bug, Daddy's just going to send it. Just going to leave it in there, let it figure itself out. If it's a big bug, I'd probably have to go in and get it. And to go in and get it, it depends on where it went, but I may have to open the motor up, which I really don't want to do. That's why I was keeping the red cover on the other day. And after tonight, I'll put the manifolds on and all that kind of stuff.
I noticed today you have those little balloon thingy whatevers and a blue paper towel.
Yep, that's covering the holes in the transmission for the transmission cooler lines, which keeps the fluid in there cooler so it works better. Mama, you got any questions? Other than why?
No, I love that they're getting educated. I don't think I have any questions.
Well, I guess that's it for tonight.
No, I have a...
Oh, okay, go ahead.
My question is, if big bugs get in there, how do you get them out?
We have to take it all the way apart. Do you want to help with that if I had to? No.
My girl.
Yeah. Well, some of the big differences in the engines, obviously, this is a Gen 1 small block. That one's actually a Gen 4, so it's got better rods and pistons inside. This one's a 283 with a 700R4 behind it, and that one is a 5.3 with a 4L80 behind it. So that's pretty much the differences. There's a lot internally that would be different. One reason the LS works so well is because it's just 50 years of research and development. It gives you so much more opportunity to make things flow better and bigger cam you can use. I mean, things like that. I'll get a little tighter video of this engine as we go along and get it ready for the stand. So thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. You can find us on Facebook at Narcoleptic Customs. And you can find us on Instagram at Narcoleptic. What do you got?
I'm going to do the end of the video.
Do it.
This is...
Graceland?
No.
You want to say, this is Narcoleptic? Okay.
This is Narcoleptic.
You got to say it loud.
This was Narcoleptic Videos.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching it. Bye, and my mom didn't say anything. I have a saying.
Okay.
get in a car wreck, do you have to take the motor out and like fix it?
Depends on the wreck. Sometimes, most of the time, no. You don't have to take the motor out. Okay, thanks for watching.